Welcome to the Hour of Harvest. It is great to have you here with us and pray you will be blessed. Sit back for the next 2 hours and enjoy while we share the good news of the gospel. We invite you to participate along with us as we sing, pray, and read the Bible in support of one another on our journey of faith. The Hour of Harvest prayer team is standing by to take your prayer request and praise reports. You may call us at 606-464-4250 anytime during this program. May this program be a place where you feel accepted, loved, forgiven, and encouraged in the Lord. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls with the unconditional love of Christ from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. Live from our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Sister Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to our service tonight. We hope that you can stay with us for the next 2 hours because we have a lot of good singing coming your way, and we're going to be talking about the Lord and try from the scripture to give you hope for a new day. You know, sometimes when life gets really rough and you're in a bad trial, you think, oh, if I can just live through this day. Well, the Lord has promises in here assuring us that we can live through that day if we're depending on Him. So for all of you that was not able to read today, this is why we take time to read for you, because when you get feeling better, you'll want to get back in the Word. And for the shut-ins and the ones in the hospitals, the nursing homes, and every place you've joined us tonight, we want you to be comfortable and just have church with us. So tonight, our scripture is from Lamentations, the third chapter, starting with the 22nd verse. It is of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed, because His compassion fail not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, saith my soul. Therefore will I hope in Him. The Lord is good unto them that wait for Him, to the soul that seeketh Him. It is good that a man should both hope and quietly wait for the salvation of the Lord. Just a very few verses here, but talking about how His mercies are new every day. And you know, we get up and we pray and we want to start the day with the Lord and have Him with us. But every day His mercies are new. And if it wasn't for Him, of course, the enemy would do us in the first day. And then it's a good reminder that the Lord is good to those that wait for Him and that seek Him. And you know, if we don't get up and pray and talk to Him, then you know, we get too busy and a lot of things happen. So what we want to do is to be reminded of what a wonderful Savior He is and how He looks after every detail of our life. And if we're waiting for Him to answer some prayers, He will do it according to His will for our life. And so that 25th verse, the Lord is good unto them that wait for Him, to the soul that seeketh Him. So tonight I trust that you are seeking the Lord. If you have any needs, we all have needs. I don't know anyone. You can't live in this world without having some needs. And so we have to choose who we're going to try to get help from. The Lord is our only help. People do a lot of covering up problems, trying to drown them out or peel them out or whatever. But the Lord is our only true help. And so tonight, as we go into the service, Dottie has phone operators up there that'll pray with you if you need to call. And just get your mind focused on the Lord and off of everything that you've gone through this week or this day. Every disappointment you've had, every aggravation that you've had today, let's lay it aside and just get our mind on the Lord and His goodness. And He said that we can find Him and He will be good to us if we seek Him. So that's what we want to do. So let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we do come to You again today to ask You for Your mercy that you've already promised that. We don't have to ask You for it, but we thank You for it. We thank You that You have promised to give us strength for our daily needs. And so, Father, as we go into this service, we ask for a special blessing on all of the singers, the phone operators, and Lord, help us some way or another to inspire others to seek you and to find out about your goodness firsthand. And we thank you because that there is so much goodness there waiting for us. And we thank you that we do have heaven to look forward to. So bless and help and deliver whatever is needed in the hearts and lives of people tonight. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, tonight we have double blessings. We have, first of all, to sing for us, we have Danny Duvall and Lisa Nall from East View, Kentucky. And then later on, we have Avery Watkins from Lexington. And so we're going to have a lot of good singing, and so be sure and stay tuned. So right now, let's go over for Danny and Lisa, and they're from East View, Kentucky, and their phone number is 270-300-6151. So let's welcome Danny and Lisa right now.
Say I thank the Lord for being here tonight. If he didn't let me be here, if he didn't let us get up and sing or anything, we couldn't do it. We're nothing without him. And I want to sing a song about what kind of man Jesus is. You can't put it all in a song. And a lot of people don't think about what Jesus went through leading up to the days when he hung on the cross and what he went through the night before. He went through the night before what we couldn't today, you know. But still, he carried the cross, and he did it. And I thank the Lord for everything. Hope you get a blessing out of us. If you're at home and you're wondering if God's really thinking about you or if he hears you, he really does. There's been times in my life that I've wondered that, but he always proved it when I went to him, you know. He healed the sick, he raised the dead. Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. He healed the sick, he raised the dead. Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. What kind of man? What kind of man? Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. What kind of man? What kind of man? Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. He walked the sea of Galilee. Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. He walked the sea of Galilee. Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. What kind of man? What kind of man? Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. What kind of man? What kind of man? Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. Made lame to walk, made blind to see. Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. Made lame to walk, made blind to see. Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. What kind of man? What kind of man? Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. What kind of man? What kind of man? Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. Tell me what kind of man Jesus is. Amen. Lisa, you got one you want to do, Lisa?
These days we'll all take a flight, and you better be ready to go. And if you're not,
amen,
there's no time like the present to get that way. Just talk to God from your heart and tell him exactly what's on your mind, and tell him you're sorry for your sins, and mean it from the bottom of your heart, and he'll forgive you. I've made plans and I'm taking a journey. Why don't you
for this flight? patiently waiting for this light that is leaving soon.
We don't know when that flight's coming, but it will be soon. I know I've heard that since I was a kid, and for somebody, every day it is sooner than they think. They leave, you know. Sing you an old song here, Family Reunion. Come one, come all, to the family reunion with the mother and daddy so sweet. Come on, come on to the family reunion. It might be the last time we'll meet. Now mother is tired, she's sick and weary, she can't go another mile. But she loves her children and she wants them near her just once more to see their smile. Come on, come on to the family reunion with the mother and daddy so sweet. Come on, come on to the family reunion. It might be the last time we'll what good will the roses do daddy up yonder? So why not give them today while he is still living and loving his children? To daddy it's better that way. Come on, come on to the family reunion with the mother and daddy so sweet. Come on, come on to the family reunion. It might be the last time we'll meet. It might be the last time we'll meet. Never know when it's the last time. It pays to be ready. You got another one, Lisa?
Let's do the Little Mountain Church. I got saved in a little church. It wasn't in the mountains, but it's a little country church in Grayson County, Kentucky. And to me, that's home. I got to go back there a few weeks ago and see a lot of the people that were there that prayed for me when I was lost. And made
that's
me feel good down
about,
deep inside just
other.
To go back.
You might think you're not helping nobody, but you are. If you're trying and you're talking to the Lord for somebody, you're helping somebody. You know?
There's a little mountain church in my thoughts of yesterday, where friends and family gathered for the Lord. There an old-fashioned preacher taught the straight and narrow way for what few coins a congregation could afford. Dressed in all our Sunday best, sat on pews of solid oak, I remember how our voices filled the air, how Mama sounded like an angel on those high soprano notes of when the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Looking back now, that little mountain church house has become my life's cornerstone. It was there in that little mountain church house I first heard the word to base my life upon. At the all-day Sunday singing and dinner on the ground, many were the souls that were revived, while the brothers and the sisters who'd gone on to glory land slept in peace in the maple grove nearby.
Looking back now, that little mountain church house has become my life's cornerstone. First heard the word to base my life upon. It was there in that little mountain church house I first heard the word to base my life upon. I first heard the word to base my life upon.
Beautiful home, beautiful land, a beautiful place on the faraway strand. Beautiful country where my friends have gone. Sorrow and pain, trouble and care, none of this has ever been there. Heaven is waiting now for me, beautiful home. Beautiful home of the pure delight, a beautiful home of the matching bride. And I know I'll live in one someday. Beautiful sights are to behold, beautiful gates and streets of gold. I will have a beautiful home someday. Beautiful robes, beautiful crowns, a glorious singing all around. Happy reunions on that golden shore. We will be there, happy and free, satisfied we ever will be, praising the Savior for His love evermore. Beautiful home of the pure delight, a beautiful home of the matching bride. And I know I'll live in one someday. Beautiful sights are to behold, beautiful gates and streets of gold. I will have a beautiful home someday. I will have a beautiful home someday. Sing a song here. I don't think you need to play the bass on a gone home. We've all got friends. We've all got loved ones that have gone home. That's proof that there's a place we're going. Somebody don't believe in God, they need to look around. Look at the trees, the water. and look at people that goes on. And you got to be ready to go on. And we think about them. At first it's sad when they leave, but then we get thinking about the good things about them. We have some happy memories. God lets us have that. So all of my friends that I loved yesterday gone home.
They have gone home.
Gone home.
They have gone home.
They've left one by one as the work here was done. Gone home.
They have gone home.
Gone
home. They have gone
home. They've joined the heavenly foe. They're walking the streets of pure gold. They've left one by one as their work here was done. Gone home.
They have gone home.
Gone home.
They have gone home.
Life here is lonely since they've gone before. Gone home.
They have gone home.
Gone home.
They have gone home.
The old weeping willow that sits by the door sadly sighs.
They have gone home.
Gone home.
They have gone home.
They've joined that heavenly foe. They're walking the streets of pure gold. They've left one by one as their work here was done. Gone home.
They have gone home.
Gone home.
They have gone home.
When the trumpets shall sound on that great judgment day, gone home.
They have gone home.
Gone home.
They have gone home.
We will see all our friends that have gone on their way, gone home.
They have gone home.
Gone home.
They have gone home.
They've joined that heavenly foe. They're walking the streets of pure gold. They've left one by one as their work here was done. Gone home.
They have gone home.
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 That's an old song. We sing a lot of old songs and do a lot of old-time things. That's because we're old-time people. That's the way we was raised up. I was raised up in old-time churches, you know, where they praying and shouting, windows open, no bathrooms, no water, no air conditioners, had a coal stove and wood stove in there. But you felt the Spirit of the Lord, and you got under conviction. That's how your soul gets born again. It gets under conviction. And that's what we're all about. That's what the ones that runs this TV station, they're real people, and they're really concerned over the Lord, and they're concerned over people. And you know, if you was ever here in person and talked to them, heard their prayers, seen how they really was. So anything you do that helps them out, I know God will bless you because they're doing it for the right reason, you know. And that's hard to find somebody that's doing something for the right reason these days, you know. You got one you want to do, Lisa?
Nothing can hold me here.
Okay, kiddie.
Some seek for wealth down here, some look for fame. I look for Jesus, with him I reign. I'm just a pilgrim here, soon I'll be gone.
Nothing can hold me here, I'm headed home. Nothing can hold me here, I'm headed home. Heavenly gates are near, and I will be long till I walk on streets of gold. Sing around God's throne. Nothing can hold me here, I'm headed home.
If I should die down here before that trumpet sounds,
when they lay my body in that cold, cold ground,
you don't have to cry for me, don't sing no sad songs.
Nothing can hold me here, I'm headed home. Nothing can hold me here, I'm headed home. Heavenly gates are near, and it won't be long till I walk on streets of gold. Swing around, got strong. Nothing can hold me here, I'm headed home. I say, nothing can hold me here, I'm headed home.
Amen. I'm glad nothing ain't gonna hold me here. People that are not ready to go think this world is a wonderful place. But if you're ready to go, you know, you realize this world is not as grand as some people try to make you think it is. Mother Earth is. God made it perfect. But the way the world is getting, and I'm glad that there's a better place I'm going someday. And glad there's a way of going there, you know. Slow it down a little bit here and... Lisa kind of hums with me a little bit in the background on this song. It talks about Jesus, the three nails is the name of the song, and hope you get a blessing out of it. 'Twas the day my Jesus died, gave his blood for you and I, the blood that stained the old rugged cross. This is a story of long ago of a man who owned a little store. It was located in Jerusalem across the street from Pilate's Hall. While he had often said, I was proud to have my name over the door. Folks came from miles around regardless of their creed. And I thought I had everything that one could need. Except for three old rusty nails on top of a shelf that I thought I'd never sell. But then one day, through the door came a big Roman soldier. And as he walked up to me, it seemed that he shook the floor. I said, can I help you, sir? In a voice that I guess to him seemed quite frail. He looked at me with a stern grin on his face, said I'd like to buy some big, big nails. I said, but three old rusty spikes, that's all I have. He said, that will do for the job I have. Three is enough. He paid me, and I was glad to have made the sale. But then I wondered, and I asked. I said, sir, tell me, what will you do with three old rusty spike nails? He said, did you ever hear of a man called Jesus of Nazareth? I said, why, you mean the one that goes around doing good? He said, that's the one. He said, today I intend to show that Jesus that he's not boss. For with these three old rusty spikes, I'm going to nail that Jesus to a cross. I stood there almost numb. You'll never know how I felt as to my knees I knelt. I said, please, sir, don't do that. But he just turned and walked away. I got up and I followed him. And through my eyes filled with tears, I could see the howling mob. Away with him, crucify him. I could hear their angry cries, and over top of all the loud noise, I could hear moans and groans of agony, and the sound of that big hammer as that big Roman soldier nailed my Jesus to a tree. So I cherish the old rugged cross, till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. That's a song to think about there, you know. Do one here about the old wagon tracks. I tell people sometimes it's maybe not the old wagon tracks you miss, but it's the old-time ways, the old-time churches. Old-time people that you knew back then, they went through a lot, but they kept on trying, and that's what we got to do today. We got to keep trying. And
All of the wagon tracks around the church are gone. We don't have neighbors anymore, we all have telephones. We used to sit on our church pews, now we sit on phone. All of the wagon tracks around the church are gone. We used to go to church to worship the Lord and King. Now we go to church just so we can be seen. Who drives a big fine car, lives in a big fine home? All of the wagon tracks around the church are gone. All of the wagon tracks around the church are gone. Don't have neighbors anymore, we all have telephones. We used to sit on our church pews, now we sit on phone. All of the wagon tracks around the church are gone. Preacher would visit that gave him a chicken from the yard. Preacher would thank him and then he'd praise the Lord. But the modern day preacher, what do you think they'd do? They'd say, I'm not going back to visit that old fool. All of the wagon tracks around the church are gone. Don't have neighbors anymore, we all have telephones. We used to sit on our church pews, now we sit on phone. All of the wagon tracks around the church are gone. All of the wagon tracks around the church are gone.
Sing an old song here, Light at the River. There is a light at the river. I like to think about that song. Key of D.
There's a deep, silent river flowing just before, and its waters are deep and wide. I can see a light, a beacon light, at the shore on the other side. There's a light at the river, a light at the river. There's a light at the river I can see. My Lord will stand and hold in his hand a light at the river for me. Dear friends and kindred who have gone before, they have crossed over waters wide and were carried away in God's love hand to their home on the other side. There's a light at the river, a light at the river. There's a light at river I can see. My Lord will stand and hold in his hand a light at the river for me. To that deep silent river I will someday come and will cross over waters wide and be carried away in the whims of day to my home on the other side. There's a light at the river, a light at the river. There's a light at the river I can see. My Lord will stand and hold in his hand a light at the river for me. My Lord will stand
a light at the river for me.
Rock cried out, no hiding place, crying hole into the Lord, crying hole into the Lord. Oh, if I could, I surely would stand on that rock where Moses stood. Rock where Moses stood.
Oh, if I could, I surely would stand on that rock where Moses stood.
On that rock's the only place to stand, ain't it? When you stop and think about it, you know, there is nowhere else.
Anything else you'll see?
If you're standing anywhere else, it's the wrong place. If you're serving any other god, you're serving nothing, you know, really, because there is only one God there. What's the one you want to do? This one here, it's called Lonely Tombs. It says, oh, how sweet is the rest in our heavenly home. And it will be, that will be pure sweet rest, you know. I was walking one day in a lonely graveyard, when a voice from the tomb seemed to say, living man, you must soon follow me to that sweet and heavenly place. Oh, those tombs,
oh, those two
lonely tombs,
lonely tombs
seem to say in a low, gentle tone, oh, how sweet,
oh, how sweet
is the
rest
in our beautiful heavenly home. From the tomb seemed to whisper and say, living man, you must soon follow me. And I thought as I looked at those cold marble slabs, what a dark, lonely place that must be. Oh, those tombs,
oh, those tombs,
lonely tombs, saying a low, gentle tone, oh, how sweet,
oh, how sweet
his rest
is the rest
in our beautiful heavenly home, in our beautiful song, but a lot of people likes it. Some people's never heard it, but I don't know if y'all ever heard it or not, but there's a lot of people around where we're from that likes it. Here's another old song. I'll face nobody's record but my own. We've all got a record we're going to face, but God made it fair. We're not going to face somebody else's, and they're not going to face ours. Okay, we're going to do one more song here. I'm going to change this to You've Been an Inspiration to Me, because everybody has been an inspiration. Just got my cue on one more song here. We're going to change it, and somebody's been an inspiration to you, and I'm going to sing it. For many years I've traveled in this slow land, and always you've shown me loyalty. Now I would like to tell you as a neighbor, you've been an inspiration to me. You've been an inspiration all through this world below. You've been an inspiration. I'm glad to let you know. You've been a friendly neighbor. And I would like to tell you, while I may, you've been an inspiration to me. I'd like to have you with me when I'm leaving to sail across to God's eternity. I know you'd be faithful then, that's always. You've been an inspiration to me. You've been an inspiration all through this world below. You've been an inspiration. I'm glad to let you know. You've been a friendly neighbor. I know you'll always be. And I would like to tell you, while I may, you've been an inspiration to me. And I would like to tell you, while I may, you've been an inspiration to me.
All right, that's a good song. I don't remember hearing that, but anyway, that's good. We appreciate this couple for driving a long distance to be with us tonight, Danny Duvall and Lisa Nall from East View, Kentucky. And their phone number to get in touch with them, I'm sure they do some traveling as much as their schedule will allow, 270-300-6151. And they will be glad to talk to you about your occasion you have coming up. And we appreciate them coming and being with us tonight. And so we have some calls in, and now Dottie has about 8 or 10 phone operators up there tonight, and they're not working hard. So call and give us a testimony or prayer request. Something could make those phones ring, because they'll feel like they haven't earned their pay, which their pay will be when they get to heaven. They don't get any here, but it's all volunteer. But anyway, it'll make them feel more useful if you call and have them pray with you or so forth. But we know on the weekends a lot of things are busy, company and kids are coming home and going and a lot of things taking place, but we know that still we have a lot of needs. But thanks again to this couple coming all the way from East View, Kentucky, and tonight's for the first time I found out where that was, so that is a good long distance. We appreciate them coming and pray for their safety in going home. All right, I told you in the beginning that we had more music. We are blessed with some more. And let's see, we have three CDs we want to show you here. And, well, if I can figure it out here. Avery Watkins is here from Lexington, Kentucky. And Avery is not new to us, but he's been coming for a good long time. And he was talking, he expected a cake tonight or something, but we didn't even get a little Debbie to give him. But we might, Don, you might still have to run to the store and get him a little Debbie cake so he won't feel left out. But anyway, I believe this is his 15th time to be here, and so he's always come with in a good attitude and working for the Lord. And his wife is with him tonight. You'll get to hear her after a while. And so right now, let's welcome Avery Watkins from Lexington, Kentucky.
Well, thank you so much. Yeah, we were talking earlier. This is my 15th time here, but I was explaining to someone before, when I'm asked to go sing, I don't turn down those opportunities. I feel like God called me to this ministry to go and sing, and if God called me, then who am I to say no? So I very much appreciate this ministry, WLJC, Sister Margaret, and we're all like family down here now, and I just love coming here and sharing, and know there's a lot of people out there watching tonight, and hopefully there'll be something in one of these songs that I share that just reach out and touch you. If you're going through something, if you need prayer, just call the number on the screen. And like she said, there's several people up there that can answer the phone. They can pray for you. They can share God's word with you. And that's what we're here to do, is to lift him up. So if there's anything that you need prayer for, just call that number and they will pray for you. My name may never be in lights on a marquee. The world may not applaud when I sing. But if I can be a light to a friend in the night, Lord, that's all that I desire to be. So remind me, Lord, you called me. Sometimes I may be weary, but if one soul is saved, it's worth it all. When I see those teardrops falling, then remind me of my calling, and may I never run from the call. When I was just a child, I knew all the while you wanted me to sing, Lord, just for you. Well, I can't count the miles. Sometimes I get so tired. But after all you've done, it's the least that I can do. Then remind me, Lord, you called me. Sometimes I may be weary, but if one soul is saved, it's worth it all. And when I see those teardrops falling, then remind me of my calling, and may I never run from the call. For the world outside is dying, full of lonely people crying. You've chosen me to tell them about you, about you. So remind me, Lord, you called me. Sometimes I may be weary, but if one soul is saved, it's worth it all. When I see those teardrops falling, then remind me of my calling, and may I never run from the call. Lord, I won't run from your call. This next song I'm going to sing, I've sang on here a few times. It's called I Was There. Got to meet a brother of mine that I consider a brother now, Tim Menzies. And he had a lot of success writing songs for country music. The song Mama Knows, he wrote that song, and several others that were recorded in the country genre. But now he's out on the road singing gospel music, writing songs. And he wrote this song, and the first time I heard him sing it, I just fell in love with it, and it's called I Was There. I was there that night in Bethlehem, and when Neil and the boys came to the moon in that tin can. At Gettysburg, Omaha Beach, and in Vietnam, I heard every soldier's cry and every mama's prayer. Yes, I was there. I was there when you took your first breath, and when you lit that stolen lucky strike and liked to choke to death, when you were waist deep in Carter's Creek and Pastor John dunked you down in the water, raised you up for air. Yes, I was there. I'm always around. I was then and I am now. And I'll be here when tomorrow comes. When a road comes to an end, I'm where you start again. I'm never farther than a word away. You've always got a friend. When your grandma passed, I was in that house. And when your grandpa ran down the streets of gold just to show her around, yes, I was there. I'm always around. I was then and I am now. And I'll be here when tomorrow comes. When a road comes to an end, I'm where you start again. I'm never farther than a word away. You've always got a friend. I was there last night on Highway 9 when you answered the phone and ran right through that stop sign. I was in the cab of that big rig in that trucker's ear. Made him swerve to the right and miss you by a hair. Yes, I was there. When you're feeling all alone, look up, I'm the one who answers prayers, 'cause I'm always there. This next song I'm going to share with you, I guess, is the closest thing that that I have of me writing a song. So I don't play instruments, so that part of it, I just have to go with what my soundtracks are. So this next song is a soundtrack for Go Rest High on the Mountain. But I wrote words to go along with it. It's called Amazing Grace for You and Me. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that it saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but Jesus found me. I was blind, but now I see. Bound in chains, I needed freedom. Jesus came to set us free. And on the cross, He paid the ransom. Amazing grace for you and me. Well, there have been days that I failed to praise Him, but then there are days when I hit my knees, 'cause I know that Jesus loves me, and His grace, it covers me. Bound in chains, I needed freedom. Jesus came to set us free. And on the cross, He paid the ransom. Amazing grace for you and me. I was bound in chains, I needed freedom. Jesus came to set us free. And on the cross, He paid the ransom. Amazing grace for you and me. And on the cross, He paid the ransom. Amazing grace for you and me. And He does give us that amazing grace. And again, I just want to reach out to you. If you're dealing with something and you need prayer, just call this number on the screen, and the people that are manning the phones will pray for you. And whatever it is, you know, this life throws some difficult stuff at us sometimes. And, you know, even as a Christian, we're not exempt. And we face some hard times. And, you know, I've been there before where you think, man, is God going to take care of this for me? Because I believe that He takes care of all things. And I know in my heart when I'm facing a tough time that He will take care of it. Years ago, I faced something that you know, it brought me to my knees, and it's like, how do you move on from this? But I knew through my faith that God would take care of it. But, you know, sometimes we have to wait because he knows the plan, the whole plan, and he sees things that we don't see. And we have to wait for his timing, and his timing is perfect. That's what this next song's about. It's called 4 Days Late. The news came to Jesus, please come fast. Lazarus is sick, and without your help, he will not last. Mary and Martha, they watched their brother die. They waited for Jesus, but he did not come, and they wondered why. The death watch was over. He was buried 4 days. Then somebody said, he'll soon be here. The Lord's on his way. Martha ran to him, and then she cried, Lord, if you had been here, you could have healed him, he'd still be alive. But you're 4 days late, and all hope is gone. Lord, we don't understand why you've waited so long. But his way is God's way. It's not yours or mine. And isn't it great when he's 4 days late, he's still on time. Jesus said, Martha, why don't you show me the grave? But she said, Lord, you don't understand. He's been there 4 days. The gravestone was rolled back. Then Jesus cried, well, Lazarus, come forth. Then somebody said, he's alive, he's alive. You may be fighting a battle of fear. You've cried to the Lord, I need you now, but he has not appeared. Oh, friend, don't be discouraged, 'cause he's still the same. And he'll soon be here, he'll roll back the stone, and he'll call out your name. When he's 4 days late, and all hope is gone, Lord, we don't understand why you've waited so long. But his way is God's way. It's not yours or mine. And isn't it great? He's 4 days late. He's still on time. Oh, my God is great. When he's 4 days late, he's still on time. Such a great song and a great message. And we just have to remember that God's right there for us. And even when it may not look like he's behind the scenes, he is. And he's taking care of things. This next song, it's called Give Me Jesus, and I've sang it on here several times, and every time I sing it now, I'm reminded of my aunt and uncle. They both passed a few years ago, and very faithful Christians and on mission for him, and we know exactly where they're at. They're in heaven, reaping the benefit and the reward of their work here on this earth. And this was one of their favorite songs, and I got the privilege of sharing this at both of their services, and just very remindful of them whenever I sing it. It's called Give Me Jesus. In the morning, when I rise, in the morning, when I rise, in the morning, when I rise, give me Jesus, give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. You can have all this world, just give me Jesus. And when I am alone, oh, when I am alone, yes, when I am alone, give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. You can have all this world, just give me Jesus. And when I come to die, oh, when I come to die, yes, when I come to die, just give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. You can have all this world, give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. You can have all this world, you can have all this world, you can have all this world, just give me Jesus. Amen. That's a good thought to start each day with. When you get up in the morning, be nice if first words out of your mouth is just, give me Jesus. When I rise, give me Jesus. All throughout the day, give me Jesus. And if we learn to go through each and every day with Him, our days will be a whole lot better. And like I said before, we're not exempt from the stuff that life brings at us, but having a relationship with Jesus, knowing Him, it makes it a whole lot better. And it makes us blessed. And this next song's called One Blessed Man, and I love singing this song because I consider myself one blessed man. Just a lot of things that God has done for me, given to me, provided for me. And I wouldn't have any of it if it weren't for Him. And so I consider myself blessed, and hopefully through my actions each and every day that I show the world that I am a blessed man, and I show them who's responsible for that, and that's Him. I've got a house to keep me warm, and it shelters me from the storm. Yes, I am. I'm one blessed man. And I've got a wife who holds me tight, and she prays for me every night. Yes, I am. I'm one blessed man. These are a few of the blessings that I have known. And if I had time, I could go on and on. Got a family and two great kids, and I don't know what I ever did to be who I am. I'm one blessed man. And I've got Jesus in my heart, and I know He won't depart. Yes, I am. One blessed man. These are a few of the blessings that I have known. And if I had time, I could go on and on. Now if someone says to you, who's that man? What does he do? Just tell them I am. I'm one blessed man. 'Cause that's who I am. I'm one blessed man. I look the part, blend in with the rest of the church crowd. I know the routine, I can list all the Bible studies in town. watch Christian TV. I know all the preachers and their cliches. I've been born again, and without a doubt I know that I'm saved. But sometimes I hurt, and sometimes I cry. Sometimes I can't get it right, no matter how hard that I seem to try. Sometimes I fall down, I stumble over my own disguise. I try to look strong as the whole world looks on, but sometimes alone I cry. I try to speak faith, never give that old devil not an inch to get in. I do worship and praise, let everybody know just where that I stand. And on the back of my Ford truck is a fish and a cross for the world to see. 'Cause I know my God is good all the time. Yes, he's so good to me. But sometimes I hurt, and sometimes I cry. Sometimes I can't get it right, no matter how hard that I seem to try. Sometimes I fall down, I stumble over my own disguise. I try to look strong, the whole world looks on, but sometimes alone I cry. Sometimes I fall down, I stumble over my own disguise. I try to look strong as the whole world looks on, but sometimes alone I cry. Yes, I try to look strong as the whole world looks on, but sometimes alone I cry. Those of you who know some of these songs probably realize I sing a lot of songs from the Crab family, and that was a Jason Crab song. Ron and I got the privilege of seeing them in concert, I guess it was last week in Winchester, and what an amazing concert. And I told someone, you know, watching sporting events, you always hear you want the players to leave it all out on the court. Well, they left everything they had on the stage because they gave it their all. They have a new CD out, and we listened to it once or twice on the way up here tonight. It's got some great songs on it, but I love their music and their spirit and what they're doing in their ministry. This next song is one that probably... of course, their dad, Gerald, wrote numerous songs that made it to number one in Christian music. And this is one of the songs, I think, that sort of gave the Crab family, their group, their big break, if you would call it that. But this is one of the songs that probably they're most known for. It's called Through the Fire. So many times I've questioned certain circumstances and things I could not understand. And many times in trials, weakness blurs my vision, and my frustrations, they get so out of hand. Well, it's then I am reminded I've never been forsaken. I've never had to stand one test alone. As I look at all the victories The Spirit rises up in me, and it's through the fire my weakness is made strong. He never promised that the cross would not get heavy and the hill would not be hard to climb. He never offered our victories without fighting, but he said help would always come in time. Just remember when you're standing in the valley of decision and the adversary says give in, just hold on. Our Lord will show up and he will take you through the fire again. Well, I know within myself that I would surely perish, but if I trust the hand of God, he'll shield the flames again, again. He never promised that the cross would not get heavy and the hill would not be hard to climb. He never offered our victories without fighting, but he said help would always come in time. Just remember when you're standing in the valley of decision and the adversary says give in, just hold on. Our Lord will show up. He will take you through the fire again. Just hold on. Our Lord will show up and he will take you through the fire again.
Amen. And if you're out there and you're going through a fire in your life, I've mentioned it a couple of times, but this program's so good about through the song sharing what God can do for us, and especially in those tough times. And they have these folks sitting up here answering these phones and willing to pray for you. So just call in and give us your prayer request and know that those will be prayed for. And God hears our prayers, and he will take care of whatever problem you're facing. Now, sometimes that may not mean that we get the answer that we want, but he will take care of it. I firmly believe that. This next song's called Sometimes It Takes a Mountain. I faced a mountain that I've never faced before. That's why I'm calling on you, Lord. Well, I know it's been a while, but Lord, please hear my prayer. I need you like I never have before. Sometimes it takes a mountain, sometimes a troubled sea, sometimes it takes a desert to get a hold of me. Your love is so much stronger
than whatever troubles me. Sometimes it takes a mountain to trust you and believe. Forgive me, Jesus, I thought I could control whatever life would throw my way. But this I will admit has brought me to my knees. I need you, Lord, and I'm not ashamed to say. Sometimes it takes a mountain, sometimes a troubled sea, sometimes it takes a desert to get a hold of me. Your love is so much stronger than whatever troubles me. Sometimes it takes a mountain to trust you and believe. Sometimes it takes a mountain to trust you and believe. Sometimes it takes a mountain, sometimes a troubled sea, sometimes it takes a desert to get a hold of me. Your love is so much stronger than whatever sometimes it takes a mountain to trust you and believe. Sometimes it takes a mountain to trust you and believe. This next song is an older song released by the Hensons several years ago. It's called "That I Could Still Go Free." Lock me up in a prison and throw away the key and take away the vision from these eyes that now can see. deprive me of the food I eat, and even bind my hands and my feet. But as long as I know Jesus, then I can still go free. That I could still go free. What kind of man would reach out his hand and do this for me? I was not fit to kill, but then a man on the cross, he puts me in his will and said that I could still go free. Well, I never could quite understand why a king would want to leave his throne to don the robe of an earthly man and feel the pain of flesh and bone. Then to later trod a lonely path that led to Calvary, where the blood red stains, they broke all of my chains and said that I could still go free. Oh, that I could still go free. What kind of man would reach out his hand and do this for me? Oh, unworthy to live, I was not fit to kill, but then a man on the cross, he puts me in his will and said that I could still go free.
Amen. And that's what he did. He put himself on the cross of Calvary just for us. He gave his life there. He took our sins upon him and carried those to the grave, and then on the third day he rose again, and he's seated in heaven on the right hand of God, and a place that's waiting for each and every one of us if we only accept him as our personal Lord and Savior. And I hope you've made that decision in your life. If you haven't, it's an easy process. He gives his love freely to us. All we have to do is accept it. And if you want to know more about that, if you're needing that relationship in your life tonight, just call this number, and these people that are answering the phones can help you with that. This is one of my dad's favorite songs. It talks about that place where we all go if we know him as our personal Lord and Savior. When this journey on earth is done, we'll go to heaven, and this is called What a Day That Will Be. Well, there is coming a day when no heartache shall come, no more clouds in the sky, no more tears to dim the eye, and all is peace forevermore on that happy golden shore. What a day, glorious day that will be. What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see, and I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand and leads me through the promised land, what a day, glorious day that will be. There'll be no sorrow there, no more burdens to bear, no more sickness and no pain, no more parting over there, and forever I will be with the one who died for me. What a day, glorious day that will be. What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see, and I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand and leads me through the promised land, what a day, glorious day that will be. What a day that will be when my Jesus I shall see, and I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace. When he takes me by the hand and leads me through the promised land, what a day, glorious day that will be. What a day, glorious day that will be. Been a pleasure being here tonight. I've got one more song, and I mentioned this earlier when I sang the song One Blessed Man. I consider myself blessed. You know, a lot of us, I guess, we get up and get going in our daily lives, and sometimes we get so busy we just forget how blessed we are, and we don't take enough time to tell God thanks. And so I just want to share with you, make sure and take time to tell God thank you for all the blessings that he's given to us. And this last song I'd like to share with you is simply called God's Been Good. Lately I've been looking back along this winding road to the old familiar markers
of the mercies I have known. I know it may sound simple, but it's more than a cliche. There's no better way to tell you than to say, God's been good in my life. I feel blessed beyond my wildest dreams when I go to sleep each night. And though I've had my share of hard times, wouldn't change them if I could, 'cause through it all, God's been good. Times replay and I can see that I've cried some bitter tears, but I felt his arms around me as I face my greatest fears. You see, I've had more gains than losses, and I've known more joy than hurt, as his grace rode down upon me, so undeserved. For God's been good in my life. I feel blessed beyond my wildest dreams when I go to sleep each night. And though I've had my share of hard times, wouldn't change them if I could, 'cause through it all, God's been good. For God has been my Father, my Savior and my friend. His love was my beginning, and his love will be my end. I could spend forever trying to tell you everything he is, but the best way that I can say it is this: God's been good in my life. I feel blessed beyond my wildest dreams when I go to sleep each night. Though I've had my share of hard times, I wouldn't change them if I could, 'cause through it all, God's been good. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much. That song goes right along with the scripture we read tonight about God is good to us. When mm-hmm. we seek him, he is always there to be good to us. Well, you've been listening to Avery Watkins from Lexington, Kentucky. He does have CDs, and his wife, Rhonda, is here. And I'm going to see if let a wife's viewpoint come out here. So tell us about his CDs, Rhonda.
Yes, I sure will. He has three. One is called For God and Country. The other one is called My Alabaster Box. And the other one is After the Storm. So he does have three. If you're interested, you can give him a call at 859-509-4912.
Okay. Now, I noticed in here we had a call. It might be in the... Mrs. Kavanaugh called and said she's having trouble with her eyes and she's wanting a CD.
Okay.
So that means she's going to quit watching me so she can listen to Avery's tape. I don't know if I like that or not, but yeah, she's a fine lady and we hear from her all the time. So we'll have to try to get her get her one. She's a good help. And all right, Rhonda, you have agreed, I think, to do some of the prayer requests tonight. So you want to share those right now?
Yes, I can do that. We have one here. It is called in by Ruby. Her last name is Sturgill from Virginia. And she wants us to pray for her husband, Kenneth. She says, needs the Lord to help Kenneth to breathe easier, and Ruby with her needs as well, and prays that their children will get where they need to be with the Lord. Mm-hmm. We have another one for Bridget Allen from Perry County. The baby was born with some problems and believes that God can move in some really good ways, and I myself knows that they can do that. I have my daughter-in-law, her nephew was born with some really serious health problems, and they didn't think he would be able to even move his legs, and 3 weeks later he's able to start moving his legs again. So we have another prayer here for Natasha. She's a 34 years old and she's in ICU in the hospital. This is called in from Charlotte and out of Crab Orchard, Kentucky. Has a lung disease and needs salvation. Prays that the Lord will save her before it is too late.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Herb from Wolf County, a praise report has come in for him from his wife, I guess, because it says, praise God, he's home and wants to continue to pray for his safety and with his physical needs. Here's the note from Ms. Kavanaugh from Madison County, enjoying the singing and would love to have a CD. She has eye issues and she needs prayer. All right, from Floyd County, a son and daughter needs prayer. Mother called in for that. From Crab Orchard, Charlotte has called for Samantha, Abby, and Gabby. All three are real sick, it says from Crab Orchard. Linda from Whitley County, COPD, having a hard time breathing. Brenda from Morgan County for her family. Here's a daughter, Wilma, has called for, she's 44 years of age, and she's a special needs person, cannot walk, and has anxiety. And Wilma is her only caretaker. But they've enjoyed the singing tonight, so that is good. See if we're able to see that they got a blessing and it being homebound. Beulah from Laurel County, allergies. Here's Pastor Gary Campbell from Betty from Wayne County from the Cooper Baptist Church. Pray that the Lord will help him as he goes through the second round of chemo. That's Pastor Gary Campbell of Wayne County. Robin Dorsey called in from Buckhorn for has muscle pain. Pray that the Lord will take the pains away and save her. All right, Montgomery County, Brenda needs prayer. Robert from Rockcastle. A lady from Pulaski County is grieving over her husband and she wants prayer for her children, grandchildren, and wants the Lord to help her family right now. Russell County, Paul and his girlfriend said they really enjoyed the singing and also needs prayer. Heather from Breathitt County needs prayer for healing. Mercer County, Mary and Kenneth. Kenneth has a lung disease and needs help. Missy from Lee County had surgery on her legs and needs help. Emery and Charles from Jackson County both have physical needs. Rockcastle, Kathy is recovering from surgery and will soon be starting treatments. Pray that the Lord will help her as she gets better with his help. Verdi from Wayne County, the Lord knows her need today, and she wants a good night of rest. You know, sometimes when you're sick, the nights get pretty long when you can't sleep. And we have George from Clay County needing a gallbladder surgery, being sent to Lexington tonight, and pray the Lord will help him. Janet from Sayersville has cancer, fourth stage, has a lot of pain. It's been a bone marrow test on Monday, and Sandy is Janet's caretaker. Janice from Bath County, enjoying the singing, watches WLJC every night. So do you have some more?
I do. This is for Fred out of London. They said they all need prayer. Thelma, she has breast cancer. For Owen, out of Breathitt, needs prayer. Called in by Goldie out of Montgomery with some health problems. For Glenda out of Whip County, needs prayer as well. For Ronald out of Pulaski, he also he needs prayer. He has had a stroke. This is calling by Virginia. As for her son out of Floyd, son's got gallbladder issues, not working very well, needs surgery. This is also out of Clay County for the Hanson families. It's some unspoken prayer request. For Harold, I'm out of Harlan. He has cancer and surgery is coming up really soon. And out of Lincoln County, it's for two sons. They are on drugs and they have been drinking. Parents are really concerned about that. Called in by Sue out of Boyd County for Sheila, and she's got the flu. For Debbie, called in out of Lexington, is in the hospital in Lexington with pancreatitis. Called in by Bobby out of Lexington, legs are swelling and hurting. Called in by Phyllis out of Laurel County, for Phyllis and her husband, and from trying to learn to walk again. There's some issues going on there, and pray the Lord will touch each one of them tonight. Out of Williamsburg, for Sid, praying that the Lord will relieve him so he can breathe with ease. And coming out of Breathitt County, a young lady there needs some serious prayer for the Lord to heal her. Pray that the Lord will comfort her and also her family. Also out of Breathitt County, for Robert, pray that the Lord will help them with their needs. For all the churches and pastors and Sunday school teachers out of Knox County, they're asking for prayer for our country. Pray that the Lord will help each of us and do what the Lord is willing to do for his work. Also from West Liberty, 94 years bedridden, watches every night and has been very sick. That's for Herschel. Out of Richmond, children and grandchildren needs prayers. This is for Thelma. Also out of Laurel County, praying for her children and her grandchildren. And then out of Perry County, for
Campbell.
The Campbell family. Really needs prayer. Looks like it says that Shirley Isaiah needs serious needs in his life as well.
Okay. All right, thank you. And we'd like to remind you that that Pastor Buddy Rhodes of the Rhodes family, he will be celebrating his 90th birthday tomorrow at the Fellowship Hall at their church from 2 to 4 p.m. So be sure and go or call him at least. He's 90 years of age, and he preached for us not long ago, did a great job. And so we appreciate Brother Buddy Rhodes. And also the Voices of Praise that you've heard on here for years, they will be singing in the morning on Sunday morning at the First Church of God here in Bayville, where Garrett Thomas is a pastor. So they've been, some of them, kind of under the weather, but we trust that they'll all be able to be there and sing and be a blessing tomorrow. All right, we'll be praying for that, and we'll give Avery, I guess we could let you talk a minute or two. used up all the time, but we'll
I normally let my singing do my talking for
me. Okay, all right. Well, how about you folk anointing those in praying, leading us in prayer, because our time is getting away, and tell us any other singing engagements that you have close nearby or close at hand.
I'll be singing in Frankfort this week, I think Friday night at the Triple Crown Cowboy Church.
Oh, okay.
I sing there quite often. And then next Wednesday night, I'll be at the Bluegrass Cowboy Church in Carlisle.
Okay.
So on Wednesday night at 7 o'clock. So I always enjoy, I sing at a lot of the cowboy churches. I enjoy their fellowship and what they're doing. So, but right now we'll pray over these prayer requests and make sure that God hears these needs.
Yes, Lord.
Father God, we just thank you for who you are.
Yes.
Father, we thank you that you hear our prayers
yes.
when we come before you. And Father, we just hold these prayer requests now. And Father, you've heard us mention these. Father, there are people that need healing, physical healing,
yes.
emotional healing.
Jesus.
Father, there's people who need salvation.
Yes.
Father, there are people who have lost loved ones, who have loved ones in the hospital, who have loved ones that are bedridden and can't take care of themselves.
Yes, Lord.
Father, we know you're the great physician.
Yes, Lord.
Father, we know that
Jesus.
You can heal any situation. But Father, we are asking right now that you
yes.
be with each one of these.
Yes, Lord.
Father,
Jesus.
That you would just provide your comfort, mm-hmm. your healing, your grace, your mercy. A touch that only you can provide.
Yes.
Father, to these people that have needs, to their families, to their friends. And Father, we know sometimes your answers aren't our answers. But Father, we trust in you that your answers are right.
Yes, Lord.
Your answers are what matters. And Father, I pray that you would give us understanding to know that you are in control.
Yes, yes Jesus, thank you.
And Father, this world would be a pitiful place if we were in control of everything. So Father, we just give you control.
Yes, Lord.
And Father, we ask that you would be in control in each of these situations.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Jesus.
And Father, we lift them up now.
Yes.
We know that you have heard this prayer and that you will respond. Thank you for this ministry. Mm. And for the work that they do. For in
yes.
Christ's name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Thank you. All right. Looks like our time is come and gone. So I trust that you have received a blessing from the Lord tonight. And if you have not been able to, just talk to him and find out why. Because sometimes we got maybe have a attitude that's not too good. And we need to kind of toss it aside. All right, we are out of time. So from all of us, we want to say good night and God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest program. We trust you are blessed every time you watch. This program is made possible by your contribution of support. Will you become a financial partner of Hour of Harvest with a one-time or monthly offering? We invite you to send your pledges of support to WLJC. Post Office Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311, or visit us online at www.wljc.com. May God bless you.
Salvation that blessed Christmas morning.